I have a question from Mr. Allen. I'd like to know, Mr. Allen, why you didn't release the silicone data when you first got it, and I wonder if you'd have a chance to complete your comments.
Sure. So the silicone data, that was originally, you know, the rule is not based on silicone at all. We do understand that it's a natural component of all beach sand. And we've got some concentrations.
Why didn't you release the data when you first got it?
Well, so when we looked at it, there was a new OSHA standard that came up, and the public was saying, we think we're seeing levels that might be exceeding that standard. So we went and got the OSHA monitoring devices to try and see, and it's a very weird standard, and try and see what those concentrations were. We only took four samples, and we saw, and the OSHA standard was like, I think it's 50 micrograms over 8 hours. And we saw, I think the highest one that we saw was maybe 20 micrograms over 8 hours. We saw one that was non-detect. We saw one that was down at like 10 or 5. But we only took four samples. And so, and we weren't doing a study. We weren't doing a public. We just wanted to get an idea to see if this was worth exploring. So there was no reason to, if we were going to release the data, we would have wanted to have done a much broader study that would give us a much better understanding of what those concentrations
were. Where did the idea come from in the first place to test for silica?
Because the public brought it up. OSHA came up with a brand new standard of that 50 micrograms, and members of the public were coming to our board saying, well, you know, we're the concentrations that we're breathing down there, if there's a majority of it is crystalline silica, we're probably exceeding even the OSHA standard. And so we agreed to to take a few samples out there. But, you know, people want to try and say we're hiding data. We weren't hiding any data. And the rule is not based on crystalline silica. It's based on PM10.
Right. So I hope this is the last we ever hear about silica.
Well, you know, it's a red herring, and I'm kind of disappointed it's even mentioned in the abatement order, the proposed abatement order, because it's really, it has no bearing whatsoever.